whether to accept the, we are in a situation, whether to accept the, whether to accept the job or keep quiet. We have to apply relevant cost method. We have to apply the relevant cost method. This is point 2. This is called as concept. This is called as concept. Point 2. Point 2A. Point 2A. So I repeat that the total cost for estimated cost is 85,500, whereas the offer is 70,000. Hence we cannot take up. But the problem very clearly says that it is an isolated job and you are in a situation whether to accept it or reject. And that situation we will not apply the full cost method. We are going to apply only relevant cost method. Okay, done. And so far it is clear. Next point, tool, a concept, and then concept you are telling, issue in the problem, second is concept. What is the concept you are applying? In concept A, now B, the point P, point B. Relevant cost method segregates the total cost into two parts. Relevant cost method segregates the total cost into two parts. Avoidable costs A and unavoidable costs B. Unavoidable costs are sunk costs. Unavoidable costs are sunk costs, not relevant for decision making. Unavoidable costs are sunk costs, not relevant for decision making. So we have to consider only avoidable costs, comma, avoidable costs or out of pocket costs and relevant for decision making. And then that's all. Instead of taking total cost, we are going to take relevant cost. Okay, start. Now friends, since you have a material, I have a book with me, so I will keep explaining. And first point is how to present it, what is the subject, materials is there, labor is there, and then overheads are there, and then other expenditure is there. The whole question is whether you take it or not and why. You have to give reasons. Okay, so at the end of that presentation how it will come. But now I have to explain you. First step is, friends, materials. I am standardizing all the adjustments, but I may be taking long time, but it's already 7:48. Okay. Materials, friends, see like this. Careful adjustment. I need 1000 kgs to execute a job, but I have 600 kgs in stock. I have 600 kgs in stock. And so what I will do, balance 400 kgs from where I will get, buy it from outside. Simple. Buy it from outside. Therefore, this is, if you want to take up the decision, you have to buy. Therefore, what you are going to pay is a relevant cost. whereas this is you are going to purchase price, current purchase price. Current purchase price, what you are going to incur is, but this is already I purchased at 30 rupees per kg. It's in, this is a sunk cost. Book value is a sunk cost. Already you have purchased. What is the use? Okay. So now for this only we have to apply relevant cost. Every material resource, material, labor will pass through these three situations only. You have to just identify. Situation one, widely used, regularly used, it will be given in the problem. For example, I have a stock with me and it will be regularly used in the business, what I am doing. If the job is not there also, I will use it. Suppose I am taking the stock and using for this job, then I have to replace it. Therefore, it is a purchase price. It is as good as you have to buy new from outside. Correct? So, that will be one. Whenever you see widely used, regularly used, immediately you should take current purchase price. Current purchase price. It can be said as replacement cost. There are three possible situations. Current purchase price. What is the money you are going to pay? Out of pocket cost. Situation two, that stock in hand is become outdated or you are not going to use it. So you have to sell it as a scrap or to some other price. That is called not regularly used or obsolete. Then resale value. That is, it is not going to be used for the purposes for which you have purchased. I buy leather and in anticipation of some good order, suddenly the order goes. I will convert leather into belts instead of shoes. I am selling it as belts. So that is called other uses. It is not bought for the purpose for which it is used. Resale value. What is resale value? If suppose this job is not there, I would have sold it to somebody. And instead of selling it to some fellow, you will sell it to him. So loss of cash inflow is the outflow. So that is resale value. This is the last one, is in great demand. The quantity with you is in great demand, not available. In great demand but not available. So like Abdul Kalam, then you should apply opportunity cost. You understand? Here you understand one thing. Suppose this material which I have is getting me material revenue 60,000 and processing cost, variable cost 20,000, and this material cost, purchased cost already is, let us say, 30 rupees. That's what I said, no? 30 rupees. So here 50 and 10. This is normal, but material is not to be considered because it's a sunk cost. So therefore, if by using this material, I am getting 60 plus minus 20, 40. This is sunk cost. Sunk cost means dash you should put. Remember, that's all. 40 rupees. This is the cost you have to take. Loss of inflow is an outflow. That's all, friends. Please note down. Any problem, only this much adjustments. Once you read materials, you please write. Widely used or regularly used. Current purchase price. Two, obsolete. Obsolete means the purpose for which you have bought is no longer there. Then third one is in great demand. Right. Now you read the problem. Tell me the answer for these three. That's all. That material A, material B, you put the answer. 2 minutes I'll give you. First note down all this. First note down all this. Then so please note down this. I repeat, meanwhile you proceed fast. Total material required for the job is 1000 kgs. I have 600 kgs in stock, purchased as 30 rupees per kg. It's a book value. Book value is a sunk cost. Now 1000 kgs I need, 600, so 400 kgs I have to buy. So the current purchase price or replacement cost is relevant. But for this, you have to take this. Now what is the situations you will go through? The every material can be like this. It can be regularly used or obsolete or in great demand. Regularly used, widely used, current purchase price. Obsolete, resale value. In great demand, I explained you, opportunity cost. Great demand, not available, two conditions. Maybe in great demand, but it's available means no opportunity cost. Over. Now I would like to see your answers. So please note down. Material A and B. Material A and B are already available in stores. Material A and B are already available in stores. Hence, the purchase price should be treated as sunk cost. Purchase price or book value. Original purchase price or book value should be treated as sunk cost. Right. With regard to material A, it is mentioned as regularly used item. It is mentioned as a regularly used item. Therefore, it will be used, regularly used item. Hence, the replacement cost should be considered as relevant. Hence, the replacement cost should be considered as relevant. Note number two. Notes number note two. With regard to material B, it is mentioned that it is an obsolete item. Obsolete. Obsolete means what? The purpose for which you purchased is no longer useful. Therefore, the resale value. Therefore, the resale value eighteen or twenty, whichever is higher, should be considered. Resale value, whichever is higher, should be considered. Stop. Here, what I have to explain is, now this quantity that I have is no longer used. So what I am going to do if this is not there? Two sources. I use it as a substitute. 20 rupees I will get. If I sell in the open market, I will get 80. What I would have done? I would have gone for 20. I'll give you another example. When you are constructing a house, the lot of, after the house completion is over, the lot of sand, cement, bricks will be left out. If you are a person builder, then what you will do? You will take all the materials and transfer it to another site where it is used. That is called regularly used item. Suppose you are an individual who constructed the house, then you won't do like that. Then what you will do? You would like to sell it as a scrap. That is the difference between regularly used item and not regularly used item. That's all. I hope you are clear. If you have any doubts, kindly raise the questions. We will answer that. So now I am explaining you, dear friends. First, you should understand what are the possible adjustments in labor. That is the same like material. Same like material, you will have three possible adjustments. That is, first situation in any company is the workforce is paid on time basis. Month end, you will get salary. Point one. Point number two, month end you will get salary. Then they are idling at present. They are idle. They don't have any work. Three, you have no intention to remove them. Remove or rotate. For example, I am having three chartered accountants. I am paying them 1 lakh rupees every month, but there is no work as of now. In anticipation of some job, I am keeping them. That means whether the job comes or not, I will pay them. Okay. Now I got a job, so I am not going to remove these 3 CAs. I'll keep them. That job requires 5 CAs. So they have charged 5 lakhs, 1 month, the job takes 1 month. Is it correct? If that question is asked, you will say, hey, out of 5, 2 people you have to appoint. So 2 lakhs is because of this job, whereas 3 people you are going to pay anyway. Therefore, this is relevant cost, this is sunk cost. Correct? So therefore, in the problem when you read that's okay, I'll come back. Next is other way around. You have to appoint or remove these people if that is not there. Then this is called out of pocket cost. This 3 CAs, I want to remove them. Suddenly job has come, so I'm going to use them. Then it is relevant cost, out of pocket cost. Relevant cost. Another is Abdul Kalam. Great demand. Then you have to take it. So you get into 3 situations. Alright. Now, here this problem, what they have asked you is, the entire job will be performed by skilled workers. Skilled workers will be carrying out the jobs. You tell me one question, when will you use an unskilled worker in unskilled jobs? Question 1. When will you use skilled workers in unskilled jobs? Suppose my wife tells me, you please go and then wash the clothes. What are you doing? I am a skilled man, but when will I wash clothes? When I don't have other work. Understand? I am idling. So my wife can tell, what is this, you go and wash. So the mere fact that skilled workers are doing an unskilled job, it means they are idling at present. Since they are paid on time basis, it should be treated as sunk cost. So please note down, labor, working not 3, I am giving. You please note down this. And now I will give notes. After that, note down. Working not 3. The entire job will be performed. Entire job, including unskilled workers' job, will be performed by skilled workers, which means that which means they are idling at present. Since they are paid on time basis, it should be treated as sunk cost. Please read it. So I repeat, because the current the battery is gone, I couldn't see you. See, the machines have three situations. I have to explain it from this. Machines, suppose a machine charge is like this. Variable cost 30 rupees per hour, fixed cost 20, profit 10, 60. There are three possible scenarios will be there, friends. One is, the machine is idle and regularly used. That is, you don't have intention to sell. Then you have to take variable cost only, which is the out-of-pocket cost. Because for using the machine, you have to spend that. Second, it is idle and for sale. If this job is not there, I will sell. So if I sell now, I will get 10,000. I will sell after 1 year, sometime after finishing the job, I will get 3,000. Fall in sale, 7,000. Third situation is, the machine is in great demand and it is already producing something for me, and per hour I will get 80. Then I have to take variable cost plus opportunity cost. So now you take the whole problem and just tell me the answer. Then I will present the whole problem, and how to present in short, I will explain. Okay, thank you. I will give you 7 minutes. So you can see like this, friends, the whole problem is like this. Estimation and material A, 2000 into 20, 40,000. Current purchase price or replacement cost as per working note 1. Material B, 200 into 24,000, resale or substitution. Other materials to be bought. Labor is a sunk cost. Overheads P1. 200 into 36,000, 400 into 8, 3,200. Planning, traveling and estimation is already done. Can you recover that? So therefore, the total is how much? 44, 60, 56, 500, 56, 62, 65, 700. So 70,000 minus 65,700, 4,300 surplus. It is a surplus to the overall fixed cost. Hence, it should be considered. That's all. Are you clear, friends? It's over.